This morning, I will speak to you how to capture the, what I call the DNA of the house. Okay, how to capture the DNA of the house. Or put it this way, how to capture the house has a head. And God put his DNA on the head of the house. And every person that comes under that vision, under that house, the DNA, you will catch the DNA. But what does that mean, to catch the DNA? Why is necessary to catch or to capture the DNA of a house? Why? Why do we have to do that? There's two things about capturing the DNA. And I will give you the definition of what the DNA is. For you to understand, many of you came from other churches. Many of you are new, so they don't have any idea how to be part of the family, of this family. So you must understand how to capture, how to receive the DNA or the spirit, another way to say it, the spirit of the house, the spirit of the vision. And I want you to write it down, please. The sign that someone has received the vision of the house is that they have captured the spirit of the vision, not the letter of it. In other words, if I'm speaking to you and telling you today, my mission on earth is to bring the supernatural power into this generation. That is my mission. God visited me. I had a visitation where God said, this is your mission on earth, is to bring my supernatural power. But for that, God needs a channel, a vessel, needs instruments, vessels, where he can channel the power. Otherwise, power can destroy you if it doesn't have any way to channel it. You understand what I'm saying? I didn't hear you. In other words, God said to me, I have called you to bring the supernatural power. In other words, the seal of this house, the main DNA of the house is the supernatural. This is a house where the presence and the power of God is manifested, not only in the services, but everywhere. I mean, I was talking to one of the ladies that park cars outside, and she was saying to me, Pastor, God has used me to heal 50 people. And she's a House of Peace leader. That woman has done more than many pastors in their lives. Can I hear an amen? Amen? So why? Because the seal, the DNA of this house is the supernatural. We minister to another areas, of course. We minister love, of course. We minister healing, of course. We minister deliverance. We minister many things. Marriages, family, we do that. Prayer. But the main seal of the house is the supernatural. So God has said to me, I want you to minister and to bring the supernatural power to this generation. So I need channels. I need vessels. I need instruments that I can channel my power. Because I can't do it myself. I need you. So understanding that, I just told you, many people, they know how to capture the letter of the vision. If I'm asking you, what's the vision of the house? Well, I told you, the mission is to bring the supernatural power. But the channel where God will release his power is through the vision. Mission and vision are two different things. Mission is what I just told you. The vision of the house is to evangelize. In other words, that power needs to be channeled through evangelism. It needs to be channeled through discipleship. In other words, what do you need power for if you don't have any vision to channel that power? Can I hear an amen, people? You understand what I'm saying? In other words, we need a channel, and that channel is the vision. That's the reason you need to capture. Say with me, capture. You need to capture the spirit of the vision, not just the letter, because just the letter means, oh, I know the vision of the house, but the question is, have you been committed? How do you know you have the spirit of the house? Because you do what I do. Can I hear an amen? If you pray for the sick, if you cast out demons, if you prophesy, if you move in the supernatural normally like anybody else, that means you got the spirit of the vision. Put your hand together and give him a big praise. Okay, so what do you mean spirit of the house? What do you mean the DNA of the house? Write this down, please. It's the ways, the forms, and how the Spirit of God moved in the head of the house. The ways, the forms, the how-tos, how to minister the anointing, how to minister the power, how to receive the healing, how to minister to the deliverance, how to minister to the sick, how to prophesy, how to minister in the power, how to enter in the presence, the how-tos. Can I hear an amen? So that is the reason God said to Moses, Moses, I want you to impart from your DNA to the 70 elders. Your ways. I have put on you the way to do things. Now you impart it to the elders. Can I hear an amen? The purpose of to catch the spirit of the house, of the spirit of a man, of the head of the house, is to carry the burden. How many of you believe that God sent you here into this house? Okay, how many of you believe, except the visitors? The visitors, I understand, but how many of you understand, Pastor, I identify with this vision. I want to be a channel to channel the power of God upon the people, to bring the presence of God. This nation needs the power of God. This nation needs the power of God, the presence of God. How many of you are called here? Let me touch your neighbor and tell him, what about you, neighbor? Come on, listen to me. Write this down. John 15:16. And I want you to write this down. I am wrapping up now. Listen. Any place that you were sent by God, it was with the purpose to serve in that place. Any place that God sends you is where God sends you to serve. Lift your hands and say, serve. Serve. Come on, say it louder. Serve. Okay, say it louder, come on. Serve. Okay. You did not choose me, but I choose you. And appointed you that you should go. What, you should what?
Go.
Help me. You should go. And what?
Bear fruit.
And that your fruit should remain. That whatever you ask the Father in my name, he might give you. Put your hands together, give him a big praise. Now, revelation is coming. I want you to write it down. Write it down fast. Listen, how many of you are called to be leaders in the body of Christ? 1, 2, 3. The rest of the people, followers, lift your hands, all the followers, please. All the leaders? Well, if you're a leader in your house, you're a leader. Pastor, I don't have anybody to follow me, but you got the two dogs and the cats, and well, you're a leader of the cats. Can I hear an amen, people? Lift your hands, come on. Write this down. So every time God said, I'm going to send you to that church, to that ministry, it's not for you to be sitting down doing nothing. He said, I want you to go and bear fruit. In other words, the sign that God sends you here is that you're bearing fruit in your marriage, in your houses of peace, in your finances, every area of your life, you are bearing. Lift your hands, come on, say it. In other words, if it's dead church, you're not gonna bear any fruit. If God sends you to a church or to a ministry where you go, God said, I sent you for you to bear. Lift your hands, say it again. 1, 2, 3, go. Fruit. Now, write it down. When you want to be a leader and you don't want to serve, you will lead without compassion. Thank you, sister. Thank you, daughter. Okay, if you see anybody in the church, they never commit to serve, God tells you, that person is leading whatever he's leading. Is leading, listen, without compassion. Because the spirit of service is what it touched your heart to serve the people with compassion. Just one amen. Come on. Write it down. Hurry up. The heart of, write this down. Number two. If God sends you to a place, it's to serve. What do you need to do first? Capture the anointing. Capture the spirit of the house. Capture. Listen to me. The moment you capture my spirit, and I'm saying my spirit, what God has put upon me, which is the supernatural, the moment you capture it, that moment you start moving in the same. Anything that comes into the head comes upon you. So in other words, I expect every member, every son and daughter of this house to raise the dead, to cast out demons, to lift businesses, to prosper, to be blessed, to be. Touch your neighbor and tell them they're talking to me, neighbor. They're talking to me. I am calling this house to bear fruit. Wow. Touch your neighbor, tell them, oh, wow. Write it down. The heart of a true leader. The heart of a true leader is that will always ask you, will never ask you something that he has never done it. If I tell you to serve, it's because that's what I do. Number three, God was the first person in doing a sacrifice. To serve implies sacrifice. Number four. One of the anointing that God has given us is to be empowered to serve. We are called to serve. Can I hear an amen? Amen. There is no service to God without serving his people. I serve God, but not man. You're wrong, amigo. You're very wrong, because you serve God when you serve the people. I want you to put your hands together and give them a big praise. Come on. No. Listen, there's no such a thing that you have a calling God without ministering to the people. There's no such a thing. You're serving God through serving people. And write this down. This is very powerful. This is very powerful. Our service to God and to our brothers is motivated by love. Didn't I tell you? Didn't I tell you that when we don't serve, we minister without compassion? And I'll tell you, Rhea, the motivation of serving the people is love. Oh my God, I wish I can hear an amen. And I finish with this one. Oh, let me finish two more. The ability to lead and rule comes from service and serve God. In other words, the ability to lead and rule comes from service. If you don't serve, you don't have any ability to guide others, not even your own children. Listen to me. I like this one. Our service to the brothers, or let me put it this way. You will serve God and the brothers to the degree that you die to self. Tell me someone that is not dead, selfish, self-absorbed, ambitious, is someone that never served God, neither his people. To the degree that you die to self is the degree that you will serve God, amen, that you will serve the people. How many of you say, Pastor, I want to serve God. I want to serve his people. Lift your hands. And I'm going to finish with this one. It doesn't take faith to serve when things are well. It takes faith when things are not going well. I am waiting for my marriage to be restored. I am waiting for my husband to be fully committed into the church, and then I'm going to start serving. I'm going to wait for my business to have 7 offices. I am waiting for my business to, I am waiting. When I got the 5 offices that God promised me, then I'm start serving. Listen, it doesn't take faith to serve God when everything is well. It takes faith to serve God when your kids are not in church. It takes faith to serve God when you have a bunch of bills that you need to pay and you don't have any job. It takes faith to serve God when you got struggle in your marriage. It takes faith to serve God when things are wrong. Let me tell you, it takes faith. God is speaking to you today and telling you, God has called you to serve in good times and in bad times. God has called you to serve. If you don't, you're selfish. Put your hands together. Give him a big praise. Give him a big praise. Come on, put your hands together. What are you saying, Apostle?